Hola a todos, saludo a nuestra audiencia. Soy Arlette Rodríguez Peña y fíjense que hoy vamos a platicar con una banda francesa que actualmente está alcanzando una importancia considerable en su nación y que no dudamos que próximamente ya sean todo un hit por todo el mundo, que es Later, quienes en esta ocasión nos van a platicar detalles acerca de una nueva producción que lanzaron en este 2023, que es Walking on the Line.
Hi guys, I'm Carla. I'm also part
Hello.
of the team of Uniradio. So now that we are talking about Walking on the Line, one of the things that I love about this album is that it comes like in full circle. I mean, it develops a storytelling, a very specific one. I think that you said on your social media how the album was about like the roller coasters of life, the ups and downs. And I think that is very portrayed in the album. Was that hard to I don't know, how did you construct this narrative?
Well, for us, when we make music, it's like very spontaneous. And so we don't really think about what we want to say. And we just like go with our first impressions, our first melodies, the first words that we have in mind, and we just make music with it. And then the narrative comes after making the music. And so we try to make sense with all those demos, all those songs that we already made. And we were like, yeah, this is really like something honest that comes from each of us. And so we kind of saying that this is like all our feelings and everything that we have experimented like the last 2 years that we put inside this, and so this is really like the DNA of the record. It's like something very spontaneous that we go through each day, how we are feeling at the moment of making each song, yeah.
Yes, because it is a very complex storytelling, especially because I think that Back to Heaven takes you to a very specific emotion. Then suddenly it's happiness, there is love, but there is also like pain, frustration. But the way that you finish the album with Lemon Tree, and I remember this line that you use in this song that says, let me find it because I have a lot of notations here in my notebook. Wait, I finally found peace under the lemon tree. That's why I say like this is full circle. You speak about human experiences, but at the end it's like all this journey and the searching of peace, right?
Yeah, this is exactly the way that that we would like to express with the album, that with a peaceful end and a quiet song that make us in peace with ourselves. So this is exactly the thing. Yes.
Yeah, it's like throughout the whole record, we're kind of living the moment, and everything happens to us, and it's like we're really in the middle of something. But in Lemon Trees, it's like you take time to reflect on this, and we actually made Lemon Trees. It's the last song we composed for the record, and so we were actually reflecting on our lives, and so we were not like living the present, but it's mostly about adding a little perspective to the record and wondering about the future. And so there are like all these new themes that aren't explored in the album, such as nature and how it's the ecological problem. So it's like something that really is far from us. And so we see that, and it's like, are we even gonna get a future? Like, you take the time to reflect on different things, and you're kind of outside the world.
That's very interesting. Yes, sorry. Go ahead.
It's also With Lemon Trees, it's also something. It's like a way that how we feel music, like something really peaceful. And with music, when we play it, we can feel a lot of different things, like something really sad, something really energetical, etc. And this is also a part of how we love music and how we would like to show this. Yes.
That's beautiful. And I think that now that you guys mentioned all this nature thing and all this ecological matter, I think that it is also reflected on the music. Because if I can speak about the evolution of your sound, I think that there is a lot of difference, like between your first songs and the one that you create for this album. They are more, how can I say, organic. Even the sound of the instruments are different. You know, like the electronic part is also there, but you hear like this protagonism of the voice. I think that the songs are full of vocal harmonizations that are amazing. Also the guitar solos, the bass line, the drums. I think you can hear the difference in that part. And it makes sense with all the things that you are telling me right now.
Yeah, I think that there is a, with an album, like you want to go like with a full vision of something. And so we wanted to go with something like very much with the soul. And so even the drums on some tracks, we didn't go with electronic drums and we went into a studio and recorded them. Paul did them. And so we wanted, yeah, something very organic and something that felt really, something that we really had made, you know, and not just through a computer, but something that from one person to another, like to deliver a message, like talking to someone.
Yes, exactly. And also, my God, Noah, you're the piano player, right?
No,
or
it's
who's?
Ah, it's me.
You know,
What's your name? Sorry, guys. You don't. What's the name of the pianist? Sorry.
It's Theo.
Theo, you
Theo, yes.
Are amazing.
Thank
really,
you.
You blow my mind each time I hear the album. I think that the way the piano
much.
Is in symphony with the voice and all the instruments is something so so beautiful to hear. So I congratulate
That's...
all of you because the work in general is outstanding, but the piano, wow, is something beyond my comprehension.
Thank you very much. But it's also Charles, the singer, is also a pianist, and we are really doing the piano together.
Oh, okay.
Even though I'm playing most of them, a lot of ideas come from. Him.
Yeah,
so.
But no, in terms of interpretation, like when there is piano, Theo is playing the piano. It's just that I can come with chords, but
yes.
He usually ends up playing them. Like all the interpretation, that's him.
Okay. Well, let me tell you that it's working, and you make an amazing and terrific team because it really works.
Thank
and
you.
I think it's very touching. The music that you are creating right now is very touching. And I think that the audience is responding to them. I mean, talking about the way your popularity is growing, not only in Paris, but I know that yesterday was a very important day in your career because you played your first headline show outside of France in Amsterdam. So how was the experience?
Yeah, that was amazing. To play a show in another country and see people who are listening our music, it's really amazing, and the feeling is great. So we would like to have more and more shows all around the world. It's a bad thing because when we release an album and music, we see all like statistics in Spotify, you know, like listeners, streams. But when you are with your public, it's not the same, and it's really different. It's really great.
Yes, I can imagine. And also not only about playing, but I can imagine the emotion that you felt, for example, when your music was played at Emily in Paris, and, you know, like this Netflix series, and your music is like getting more and more popularity each day. I mean, also last month you were on the Celine fashion show, so guys, that's a huge thing. Not every person have that opportunity. So tell me, how was the Celine experience?
Well, we're really, I think that each event, like for us, it's a big surprise because mainly we're really focusing on the music. And so we're kind of like all these things that happen to us because we release music, mm-hmm. like it's just bonus, you know? And so when we're invited to these kind of events, for us, it's a great honor, of course, but I don't think that we realize it, you know? It's just like a...
Okay, and
I think that the more we have, it's just about sharing the music. And if you get this type of things, it means that you're spreading it more and more. And so this is really our main goal, I think, is that the most people listen to our music.
Yes. But also I ask about the Celine fashion show because I think that Jack White was there. Catherine Deneuve, I mean, like a lot of cultural royalty was there. So you are part of this now. And I don't know, I think that as an artist, that's a huge thing.
Yeah, I think that for us, it was an amazing experience because it's not, I think that we don't feel like we are part of this world and these okay. Famous people, etc. at the moment. So every day we are making music and playing music, and one day you are invited to go to Celine show. So it's kind of strange feeling, but if we are going there. Noah, Paul, and Charles together, so it's like a funny experience and very interesting also because it's a world that we don't know.
Well, get used to it because I'm pretty sure that you will receive lots and lots of more invitations to this kind of events because I think that you earn it. You're really great. You're a great band, guys.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
And also about now the changing a little bit the subject. Here, Ilse wants to ask one more question.
Okay, guys. And finally, at this moment, Paris has and is experiencing convulsive moments. What do you do? What do you do things are citizen of France?
It's a bit complicated to talk about that, I think, because we are just playing music and promoting it, but of course we are Parisian and this is a kind of a strange thing also for us. So yes, I don't know really what to say, but for example, I've been in the streets too recently and yes.
Okay, how does music help you in this?
It's not help, but help really for the with this situation. It's it's not really dramatic in Paris at the moment. Mm-hmm. It's a kind of just people going in the street to make show that.
They don't agree
with the mm-hmm. with the government, but the music is it's just the way you found it's just our job, so we worked on our music and we can have or different advice.
Advice
opinion on the situation. But yes, in Paris, it's not the revolution actually. There is just manifestations and that's all.
Okay.
I think.
Yeah, I get you. But
yes.
I don't know, as I said before, you're doing a great job, especially now that this album, I found like these references to soul music, disco, even doo-wop and the chill wave and down tempo that is also very characteristic of your music, and it works. I think that the journey that you are taking right now in your music is the right one. And I don't know, we are looking forward to see what's coming next with you.
Yeah.
And also, can I ask about your the band's name? Why later? And especially because it has like a period, like later, period. That's an statement. So tell me about it.
Yes, that period was kind of important for us. For us later, it's mainly about, we feel that everything, nowadays, everything happens very, very immediately. You know, when you want something, you get it. Like everybody is in constant connection with each other, with social media. And so for us, we wanted to respond to this in saying that it's okay, you can take your time. And this is what we wanted with our music, like to be a space where you can really reflect and appreciate things and don't get caught in all the other stuff that doesn't matter. And for us, it was like,
okay,
you're not gonna tell us when to make music, what music, what kind of music to make, if you have to get in the groove, in the everything that's working at the moment. I don't know, popular music that you listen on the radio. Like, we're gonna do what we feel right and what we feel at the moment, and always try to be as honest with what we produce. So this is like, if you want us to make something that isn't like what we decided, like, you can call later. That's the message.
That's amazing. That it's a very intelligent name, I think. So before we let you go, guys, can we ask you for a favor? Could you please send a message for our listeners in order to use the audio as an ID? I don't know, maybe introduce yourself and saying that they are listening to Uniradio.
Okay.
Yes, of course.
So, hi, this is Later, and you're listening to Uniradio. Sorry.
again, don't worry.
Hi, this is Later, and you're listening to Uniradio.
Perfect. Thank you, guys. Again, congratulations for this.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Muchas gracias.
A ustedes. And I don't know, maybe sooner than later, we're going to see you here in Mexico.
Yeah, we hope so. It's a big dream.
Okay. So let's achieve that, please.
Yes.
Thank you, guys. Goodbye. Thank you.
Goodbye.
Adios. Goodbye.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you
very
much.
Have a nice weekend. Bye-bye.
Yes, you too. Bye-bye.
Bye.